Hello students, welcome to the 11th class on economic survey, and in this class I will be dealing with the 11th chapter of economic survey year 2017. Now the name of the chapter is One Economic India for Goods and in the Eyes of the Constitution. Now this chapter is very interesting. This chapter is very enlightening, and this chapter will really help the public administration and economics optional students. Plus this will also yield something for the political science optional students too. Now what is this chapter about? First of all, now this chapter is about the trade. This chapter is about how the states of India, they perform in this domain of trade with other states, trade within themselves, and this is also about India's trade, that how India is trading within itself and how India is trading outside. Now as far as this chapter is concerned, I have divided it into three parts. In the first part I will be dealing with the difference between Economic United India and Political United India. In the second part, I will be dealing with certain issues about how different states are performing in the domain of trade. Performance of states in the domain of trade. And lastly, I will be dealing and doing the comparative analysis of the provisions of trade and commerce in the Constitution of India and the provision of commerce and trade in the United States of America, in European Union, and as per the rules of WTO. So in the last part I will be doing the comparison and how India is making efforts to become economically united India. Now let us start from what is meant by political united India. Now political united India basically means that we have India that is politically united all over India. The same laws applies, Indian Penal Code applies, the Constitution applies, CRPC applies, CPC applies. The Indians, they enjoy same type of freedoms. Now if somebody is in Punjab or somebody is in Kerala, both will be enjoying this Article 19 of the Constitution. In the same manner, there is no kind of disparity, there is no kind of bias. But when it comes to economic united India, India is less economically united. Now what is meant by economic unity? Now economic unity means that there is no uniformity about the tax laws. Now why there is no uniformity? There is no uniformity because India has been created out of the fight against the British. India is a huge landmass, and because it's a huge landmass, there exists diversity of people. Mass disparity, mass diversity, disparate cultures has given birth to different type of ideologies, and this is the reason that why India has adopted this federal form of governance. In federal form of governance, you basically share the power with the center and the states. Now the states, they have been given powers for taxation, for value-added tax to apply. They have been given power to apply excise duty. So this VAT and excise and other state-based taxes. There are about 20 such taxes. Now these taxes, they differ from one state to another state. So there is no uniformity. Now if VAT is applied on something, X commodity in Gujarat, in that case, if 5% is the VAT duty, VAT tax, that in that case, it might be 8% of the VAT in Maharashtra. So the same product might cost you different in Maharashtra and the same product might cost you different in Gujarat. There are also instances whereby some states have been given leverage. Some states have been provided leeway of how they decide about their taxation structure. Now take the case of Uttarakhand, take the case of Himachal, take the case of the northeastern states. The central government has provided these states freedom from the tyranny of the taxes. There are certain taxes that are not levied in these states. So there is a kind of tax subsidy given to some states. So this basically creates a loop-sided taxation landscape in India. Kuch states mein zyada taxes hai, kuch states mein kam hai, kuch states kaun se taxes zyada lagati, kuch state kam taxes lagati hai. So this is a generalized thing about the Indian tax system existing under this federal scenario. So federal taxation scenario is something that is heterogeneous, it is not homogeneous, it is not uniform. So in such a scenario, it is not possible to integrate India economically. So we don't have economically united India, though we have political united India. Now, we must also know something about the trade. Now, as far as the internal trade in India is concerned, it is 52% of GDP. 52% of GDP is the internal trade in India. And internal trade in India is 1.6 times that of international trade. And in case of China, it is 1.5 times to that of international trade. And in United States of America, it is 2.5 times to that of international trade. Jitna Hindustan international trade karta hai, usse 1.6 times zyada hamara internal trade hai domestic. Gujarat kisi aur states ke saath trade kar raha hai, kuch aur states kisi aur states ke saath trade kar rahi hai. This is what is meant by internal trade. Trade within the country, trade not crossing the international borders. So we have a higher share of the internal trade, that is known as domestic trade, but international trade is less. But India's case is more comparable to that of China and it is less comparable to that of United States of America, because in the case of United States of America, we have 2.5. United States of America is more economically integrated. Unka internal trade hi bahut zyada hai. 2.5 times more that of international trade. Agar international trade 100 billion ka hai, to usse 2.5 times unka domestic trade hai, aapas mein states jo kar rahi hai. So we will, in the latter part of the lecture, we will be dealing more about United States of America. So till now, this much is sufficient. Now when it comes to the states in India, we have different states, we have smaller states, we have larger states. Now in case of India, the smaller states like Goa, like Uttarakhand, like Himachal, these are the states that rank very high in terms of the trade that they conduct, the trade that they indulge in. And on the other hand, we have states like Maharashtra, we have states like Tamil Nadu, which don't rank high in terms of the total trade. Now, what is meant by total trade? The total trade of a state, it means imports of that state and exports of that state. Now, in this case, Himachal, Uttarakhand and Goa, they rank very high. The total import plus export is very high. And then we have a case of Maharashtra. We have a case of Tamil Nadu. We have a case of Haryana. We have a case whereby these states, they export a lot. These are export-oriented states. Export means just the domestic export. But when it comes to Uttarakhand, when it comes to Himachal, these are the states that don't export. These are the states which have trade deficient. So very important thing here is to learn about trade deficient states. Zyada agar trade dekha jaye import plus export, to Uttarakhand, Himachal aur Goa zyada karte hain. But when it comes to kaun si state aisi hai jo export kam karti hai, that is Uttarakhand, then you have got Himachal. Now why this is being taking place? Why we have a scenario whereby a case is of a state which is very high in terms of total trade but it is lacking in exports? It is due to the taxation structure peculiarities. Very important to understand. Taxation structure peculiarities. Himachal mein aap bahut zyada invest karte ho kyunki wahan pe aapko tax subsidy mil rahi hai. तो स्टेट का इंपोर्ट जो है वो इंक्रीज हो जाता है हिमाचल का. बट एक्सपोर्ट क्यों नहीं इंक्रीज होता है? क्योंकि सपोज एक्स कंपनी है, एक्स कंपनी हैज इन्वेस्टेड इन हिमाचल. इट हैज इन्वेस्टेड अबाउट 2000 करोड़ रुपीस इन हिमाचल. इन दैट केस लॉट ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल विल बी कमिंग टू हिमाचल टू प्रोड्यूस अ पर्टिकुलर कमोडिटी कॉल्ड वाई. वाई इज द एंड प्रोडक्ट. And this end product will be created once you have created this Z product. Now what a company X will be doing, it will be creating this Z product. And then it will be transferring this Z product to, let us suppose, Maharashtra, where this end product Y will be produced. And then when this Z will be, product will be transferred to Maharashtra in order to produce this Y product, this will not be categorized as export. This will be just intra-firm trade. So this is something that you must clearly understand, because as far as this year's economic survey is concerned, it has clearly dealt with what is meant by intra-firm trade and inter-firm trade. Now what is meant by inter-firm trade? Inter-firm trade means one firm is X, the other firm is Y. Both these firms, they are not related to each other. X firm is producing something else, Y is producing something else, the trade is being conducted. Now, other you have got the intra-firm trade. Now, intra-firm trade in India is taking place because of the tax structure peculiarities, because you derive benefits out of it. Now, when this Z product is shipped to Maharashtra in order to produce this Y end product, it attaches this form F. Now this form F offers a special kind of exception to this Z product, whereby during its transit to Maharashtra, it will not be liable to pay tax. Very, very important. Form F. So basically, what I want to focus here, is that there exists certain taxation peculiarities in case of Indian taxation landscape, because of which certain states are deriving benefits of it and certain states are not able to derive benefit of it. And we have a peculiar case of Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand, which are deriving benefits because of this thing. Now, another thing that we need to understand is about the gravity model, and then we'll be applying this gravity model in order to understand this trade aspect in detail. So what is this gravity model? It relates to geography. in gravity model says that suppose there are two states and they are separated by a distance r. Now let us suppose that there is A state and B state. Now if these two states are rich, then there will be more trade as per this gravity model. Richness aspect. And in case of states, we will be taking it as GDP. Now if the distance will be less, in that case the trade will be more. So this is the end result of this gravity model. Now when we apply this gravity model to India, both these conclusions, they stand the test. In case of India, the state that is contiguous, the states that lie close to each other, that share boundary, they tend to trade more. And this is what is highlighted by this gravity model of trade. And it is also true that the states which are high in GDP, they also tend to have a higher trade affinity. Their propensity to trade is more. Zyada trade karti hain wo states jo aapas mein paas hain. And this test stands clear in case of India. Now we have another factor, that is the factor of language, that has also been highlighted by this year's economic survey. Generally hum believe karte hain ek language ek aisa inhibiting factor hai jo aapko trade karne nahi deta hai. But this year's economic survey has highlighted that language is not a big barrier. Through the statistical figures, it has been highlighted that this language is not acted as a dissuading factor. Language ki wajah se nahi hai ki trade nahi kar pa rahi hai states. But as far as this chapter is concerned, the most important thing is to discern the constitutional provisions about trade. Now in Constitution of India, we have certain articles like Article number 301, Article number 302, Article number 303, Article number 304A and 4B. Now these articles, they deal with the aspects of trade. Article 301, now why we are learning this? We are learning these provisions of the Constitution of India in this year's economic survey because these provisions will tell us what is the nature of the Constitution of India with respect to the trade. Ki hamara samvidhan kitna trade promote karta hai ki nahi karta hai. So we will be learning about this aspect. So as far as Article 301 is concerned, it says that the interstate trade, the intercourse will be actually free. Intercommerce will be free. No charges should be levied specifically apart from the taxation. So the taxation will be free, notwithstanding any other condition. The trade will be free. The second, the 302 article relates to the power of the parliament by which the taxation, by which the restriction on the trade can be imposed in the interest, in the public interest. So the key word here is public interest. So if the public interest is being hurt, in that case, the parliament can make a law. It can restrict trade. It can restrict commerce. It can restrict how the trade is being conducted. So this power has been conferred onto parliament. Now 303, neither parliament nor state will have the power to be biased towards or against any state as far as the trade is concerned. Na to parliament na hi state government koi aisa kanoon bana sakti hai jisse wo ek particular state ko promote kare trade karne ke liye. एक बायसनेस नहीं दे सकते हैं, ऐसे नहीं कहते कि महाराष्ट्र से जो प्रोडक्ट्स आएंगे उन पे टैक्स नहीं लगेगा, जो ओडिशा से प्रोडक्ट आएगा उससे टैक्स लगेगा. Such kind of provisions are not allowed in the Constitution of India, as per Constitution of India. So, what this article promotes? This article promotes uniform national treatment, UNT. You cannot be biased towards a particular state. Now, then we have got Article 304A and 304B. Now, this Article 304, it relates to states. Now, 304B relates to public interest. Now, keeping into consideration public interest, state legislature can impose restriction on trade and commerce and intercourse. Intercommerce. So, state ke paas power hai, but is tarah ka law state tabhi bana sakti hai agar wo president of India ko. President of India से permission ले. So it is only with the concurrence of the President of India such a bill can be introduced in the state legislature. So restriction की जो power है वो state को भी दी गई है हिंदुस्तान के संविधान में. और एक और provision है Article 304A. 304A क्या कहता है कि state government के पास power है अगर आपने किसी particular commodity के ऊपर tax लगाना है किसी और स्टेट की से जो आप इंपोर्ट कर रहे हो कमोडिटी अगर उसके ऊपर आपने टैक्स लगाया है इन दैट केस यू शुड आल्सो बी इंपोजिंग दैट सेम टैक्स ऑन द कमोडिटी दैट विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन योर ओन स्टेट और दैट इज बीइंग प्रोड्यूस्ड इन योर ओन स्टेट. इट मींस दैट यू कैन नॉट बी बायस्ड. योर टैक्सेशन स्ट्रक्चर कैन नॉट बी बायस्ड. So basically अगर हम चारों आर्टिकल्स को पढ़ते हैं तो ये एक चीज कन्वे करते हैं. फर्स्ट दैट बायसनेस नहीं होनी चाहिए. दिस इज द वन थिंग दैट इज वेरी क्लियर दैट वी कैन नॉट बी बायस्ड टूवर्ड्स अदर स्टेट्स. एंड द सेकेंड थिंग दैट यस देयर कैन बी रिस्ट्रिक्शंस. देयर कैन बी रिस्ट्रिक्शंस इन द ट्रेड. आर्टिकल 303 बोलता है कि पार्लियामेंट रिस्ट्रिक्ट कर सकती है इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट. एंड आर्टिकल 304B बोलता है कि इन द पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट स्टेट कैन रिस्ट्रिक्ट दिस ट्रेड एंड कॉमर्स. नाउ वी विल बी कंपेयरिंग. हमारा संविधान ही कहता है कि रिस्ट्रिक्ट कर सकते हो. सो बेसिकली व्हाट मैसेज इट गिव्स इट गिव्स अ मैसेज दैट दो ट्रेड इज फ्री to be conducted in India, but it is not relatively restriction free. Restrictions can be imposed, but when it comes to, because states have been given power in the federal system to restrict the trade, but when it comes to United States of America, agar United States of America mein ka hum sanvidhan padhte hain, constitution padhte hain, the residuary list in case of United States of America, though is with the states. Now in case of India, you have the state list, union list, concurrent list and residuary list. And concurrent and residuary list, they are with the center. And despite both these lists being with the center, states still can impose restrictions on the trade. But in the United States of America, though the residuary list is with the states, but still the states in the United States of America, they cannot impose restrictions. Restriction cannot be imposed in the United States of America. And this is the reason that in the initial part of the lecture, I have told you that the internal trade in the United States of America is 2.5% to that of international trade. Now, in case of India, the internal trade is 52%. This is also very high. But we can reach more higher limits with respect to internal trade. Now, when we compare India with that of European Union, Maastricht Treaty, it allows the freedom to trade, the freedom to trade in services, the freedom to trade in goods, and the easy transfer of the people. So, United States of America and European Union, they are better placed in comparison to India in terms of trade. This is a very important thing. And when we study the provisions of WTO, even in case of WTO, there is Article 20, which has come out with the exception list of the public interest under which the restrictions can be imposed. So there is a defined list of the issues about public interest under which the restriction can be imposed. But हिंदुस्तान के संविधान में जो आर्टिकल 302 और 304 मैंने आपको पढ़ाया है, नाउ बोथ दीज आर्टिकल्स दे डोंट हैव अ लिस्ट अबाउट पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट. सो पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट इज अ सब्जेक्टिव मैटर इन केस ऑफ इंडिया. किसी भी चीज को आप बोल सकते हो कि ये पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट है, हम ट्रेड नहीं होने देंगे. सो दिस इज अ काइंड ऑफ फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी दैट इज इन इंडिया. नाउ व्हाट शुड बी द सॉल्यूशन? द सॉल्यूशन शुड बी to make borders more porous. How can that happen? And there is one more peculiarity about trade in India, that intrastate trade is relatively less in comparison to interstate trade, and that is because of the higher rate of value-added taxes that is imposed by the states, then the central state tax that is levied by the center. So, what India needs to do? India needs to usher in a uniform taxation regime whereby the tax structure is not biased or inclinated for a particular state. And this will be done with the introduction, with the ushering in of the GST. So, the introduction of the GST will help us in ushering economically united India. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you are interested in getting your query addressed about these economic survey classes. You can also install our application. Name of the application is BrainyIAS. You can find this application from Google Play Store and from App Store. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.